Okay, so some of the props I have for my restorative yoga class tonight are blocks. If you have some, great. If you don't, you're gonna make it through this just fine. Also, I don't know, you can get these at Target or online, and when Ross is open, which maybe it will be again in a month or something, I got these there for $2.99 each, so that's kind of nice. I have yoga bolsters, these fancy square rectangular stiff pillows. They're really dense, so good for supporting the body. I have yoga blankets. These are just like the wool standard yoga studio blankets. You might want like a fuzzy soft blanket that you can put over yourself if you're cold, maybe a pair of socks. And then I'll also demonstrate, these are just my pillows off the couch, so I'll demonstrate how to use some of the poses, or how to do some of the poses using couch pillows too, in case you don't have the fancy yoga stuff, which is completely not necessary to do this practice. So we'll start in a comfy seat. So we'll just start to begin. You can set up a bolster or something to sit on if you like, if you want to prop your hips up. We won't be here too long. We're going to start with a pranayama exercise lying on the ground, and then we'll move towards our restorative postures. So we'll just start in a seated position. And I brought a Mary Oliver poem tonight to read to you guys because I feel like it's fitting for the season that we're in and what we're going through with this whole quarantine. And so I'd like to share this with you. So take a comfortable seat. One of my yoga teachers used to say, as if you could just snap your fingers and tune into stillness of the mind. Just imagine that now, like you could snap your fingers and you've settled down. Once you've done that, let your breath start to breathe a little bit deeper. Tonight we'll focus a lot on long exhales. A long exhale is going to kick in your parasympathetic nervous system. So that's the part of our nervous system that's activated right before we get good sleep. The parasympathetic nervous system activates when we're calm, right? When we're reading the news or scrolling through social media, sometimes on our phones, that might not be the parasympathetic nervous system that's kicked in. That might be the sympathetic kind of fight or flight ready to activate and, you know, help us through a stressful situation. And so what we want to do tonight is tune into deep exhales and a sense of calming that comes from the parasympathetic nervous system. You might even take a big exhale or sigh out of your mouth as we get started here. Just let it go. We've all been going through a lot. So take a big breath in. Big exhale, let it go. And I'm going to read you this poem. It's by Mary Oliver. The poem is called The Hurricane. It didn't behave like anything you had ever imagined. The wind tore at the trees. The rain fell for days, slant and hard. The back of the hand to everything. I watched the trees bow and their leaves fall and crawl back into the earth as though that was that. This was one hurricane I lived through. The other one was of a different sort and lasted longer. Then I felt my own leaves giving up and falling. The back of the hand to everything. But listen now to what happened to the actual trees. Toward the end of that summer, they pushed new leaves from their stubbed limbs. It was the wrong season, yes, but they couldn't stop. They looked like telephone poles and didn't care. And after the leaves came blossoms. For some things, there are no wrong seasons, which is what I dream of for me. You can bring your hands to your heart. Take a big breath in. With a big breath out, you can bow your head into your hands and just take a moment to maybe dedicate your practice. Maybe set something on your own heart. Maybe set something clearly in your own mind. And So for our first posture, we're gonna come to lie down flat on our belly. Okay, so you can move stuff out of the way of your mat, and we'll just be here for a couple breaths. This is a really lovely pranayama. If you're ever stuck and can't sleep, this is an excellent one to practice before bed, or to practice even crawling out of bed and breathing this on the floor and getting back into bed once you feel calmer. Okay, but what we're gonna do is lay flat on the belly. I hope you can see this. You're gonna take your hands, you can make a little pillow with your hands, and then set your chin on your hands. Your legs can just relax however they are, and we're gonna take 8 steady breaths here. So I'm gonna let you count your breaths, I'll count mine. Okay, so just steady in and out breaths. Every time you exhale, really try to let everything settle into the ground. Every time you exhale, feel your front body just deeply melting into the floor. And what you'll notice in this breath is your breath into the low back and low belly. You can close your eyes if you haven't. You'll feel your breath filling up into your low belly. Your low belly will press onto the ground. You'll feel your breath filling up into your low back, into the sacrum, and even shifting your pelvis on the floor. Let your breath fill into your low back. When you exhale, maybe you're letting go of a little more than breath. Maybe you're letting go of some mental stress, certain thoughts or ideas. Maybe you're just letting go of all the worry or fear or cares you've had on your mind. Good. Let's say we finish our 8 breaths, or we just have one more. So take one last comfortable breath here, fully feeling that release into the low back and belly. Take a moment to let your breath return to normal here, and then just notice your mind. So again, this is a breath that forces our breathing into the low belly. So before you go to bed at night, your belly breathing, and this breath forces our breath there. It should start to kick in the relaxing or parasympathetic part of our nervous system. So as you're ready from here, we're gonna pull our hands by the sides. And we're gonna shift back towards a child's pose. So set your knees on your mat. Okay, and this child's pose could go a few different ways. So if you have a bolster, that's gonna be a lovely thing to place under your belly here. You can open your legs wide, bring that bolster in, and lay belly down here. Okay, if you had blocks and couch pillows, okay, you could put blocks underneath, 2 blocks like so. You could place your couch pillows on top and just make a comfortable platform to rest your belly, right? It's not super important how that is underneath, as long as it feels comfortable, as long as you can rest your belly on it and let yourself feel supported. So the idea of these restorative yoga poses is that we take the pose and then we stay for several breaths, or beyond several breaths, into a few minutes. Generally 2 to 5 minutes we'll spend time in these postures. So in the first few moments of the pose, and sometimes I'll come out so I can talk a little bit easier, in the first few moments of the pose, take time to really get comfortable. So take time to move around, take time to adjust your props. If you're in a pose and feeling uncomfortable, it's not going to be relaxing. So just give yourself the time to fit your props in a way that feels good, so that as you take your child's pose, as you take any of these postures, you can rest completely. Right? If the mind is or if the body is uncomfortable, the mind won't rest. So in this pose, you can turn your head to one side. We'll spend the first couple breaths here. And really feel the weight of your body starting to give in to those props. Notice any tension in your hands or feet. Up your arms into your shoulders. Relax the arms and shoulders. Feel your hips relax heavy into the heels. Allow yourself to stay, and for a moment, just knowing that there's nowhere to go.
There's nowhere to be as we stay here in this child's pose for another minute or two.
If you've had your head to one side this whole time, take a moment to turn your head in the other direction. So this posture does offer a little passive stretch for the neck. So if you've spent time with your head one way, take the rest of our time in this pose with your head gazing off in the other direction. And we'll stay another minute and a half, and as we rest here, just start to tune into what is it that you could let go of physically? Or what is it that you could let go of mentally? And so you've chosen to set aside this hour tonight to take care of your body, to take care of your mind, right? So really go all the way by bringing the mental space right here and right now. Right? You'll have a lot of time later to think about all the things. So for now, right? Tuning all the way in. There's probably something you could relax a little bit more. See if you can find that space, and for the last 20 seconds or so, relax a little bit more. So I'll start to alert you when it's the last few breaths of each pose. And so now, not moving out quite yet, but maybe giving yourselves 3 to 5 more deep breaths. Allow your last few breaths in the pose, maybe really filling up all the way, enjoying that breath all the way down your back, into the low spine, into the sacrum. Feeling everything fill up, 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 and then when you exhale, letting go, maybe even sighing out of your mouth. Last moments here. And so as you're ready, you can turn your head forward, turn the chin forward, and then just pull your hands in by your sides. I'm just going to use my arms to press myself up. I'm going to move my pillows aside for my next pose.
Now, if you guys want to take a downward facing dog or something more active in between, go ahead. I'm already feeling pretty tired tonight, so I'm going to stay low to the ground. I'm going to stay on my mat. And I'm just going to turn over to lie on my back. So for now, just come on down to rest. As you're ready, you can pull your knees into your chest. You could rock a little bit left to right sides here as we turn over. In a moment, we'll be in our next pose. Okay, so next posture, we're gonna take our feet to the ground. You can let the soles of your feet turn together. Knees are gonna open wide. So reclining bound angle pose or Supta Baddha Konasana. Okay, and so a few ways to prop up this pose to be more comfortable. If you have blocks at home, your blocks could set underneath your knees. You can note your blocks have a few different levels, so turning them on level one or up to level two, you could put your blocks. Okay, hopefully all of us at least have those sweet couch pillows, so you could grab pillows from your couch. Place them underneath the hips and let the knees just fall open into the pillows. If that wasn't enough support from your couch pillow, you could fold it double, right? So it's higher. And with the feet together, we'll let our knees fall open to either side. Okay. Another thing you could do here if you wanted, I have another couch pillow. I'm gonna put that under my head. Super comfy, right? You can get all the way snuggled up in these poses. I also mentioned having blankets. So if you wanted to put a blanket maybe all the way over your body or maybe over part of it or just over your belly, so there's a little bit extra weight on your body, you could go ahead and cover up with a blanket. You can let your arms reach out to the sides. So different arm variations for this pose. You could reach your arms up overhead. That is going to feel a little more energizing or a little more active. Okay, so arms could go up. You could reach your arms out to either side, straight out like a T or down by the hips. Okay, any of those options will do really well. Good. And again, we're going to be in this pose for another couple minutes. Okay, so again, using the first 20, 15, 30 seconds of the pose to really get comfortable, adjusting your props in a way that feels nothing short of amazing. And then once you feel completely comfortable with your props, we'll start to give into the pose. So don't worry if your knees don't fall really far open. If your knees, or if the inner thighs are tighter, if the musculature is tighter here, and the knees are higher up, just continue to put pillows or props underneath them until your props meet your legs. So don't worry if the legs don't fall open too far. That's not a problem. I like a little bit of weight on my belly and chest in these poses, so I'm going to put a folded blanket over my chest, over my belly, just to provide a little weight. Okay, that weight can also be calming to the nervous system. Feel the weight of your back on the ground. Let your back muscles start to melt and relax into the floor. Every once in a while, come back to the hips, come back to the knees. Feel the knees get heavy and soft and open a little more and a little more. Feel your whole pelvis and let whole pelvis relax. Feel the back of the hips on the floor, the glutes. Everything melts into the ground. from your fingertips to your palms, to your arms and your shoulders. Let the whole upper body relax. Relax your neck and throat. Relax the jaw joint in the mouth. Let your teeth separate slightly inside of your mouth. Let your lips relax. Let your tongue relax inside of your mouth. Relax the eyes. You don't have to control your breathing at all in these poses. The breath is the same as right before you fall asleep at night, and you're just breathing normally and naturally. You'll notice some breaths will be longer, some breaths will be shorter and more shallow, and all of that is fine. Allow yourself to rest deeply. So we'll come towards our last few moments in this pose. And again, I'll always give you that warning. So use the next few breaths to really take deep inhales, feel the belly, upper chest expand. Exhale anytime it feels good to take a sigh out of the mouth. You could open the mouth and sigh out. Last couple deep breaths here, just to really enjoy the last few moments of goodness in this pose. As you're ready to come out and start moving, you might stretch out, you might reach your arms up overhead, just like a gentle waking up. You might press your chest up off the floor. We'll reach down for the knees and grab underneath both knees with your hands and use the hands to pull your knees up to center. Okay, if there's anything on the body, you'll move it off and then pull your knees into the chest. That last pose puts us into a slight extension in the low back. So taking a counter pose with knees into the chest should feel good to the lumbar spine. If there's any other way you want to stretch out before our next pose, go ahead. As you're ready, you can roll to one side. You'll just take a moment lying on your side. And from your side, you can press yourself up. Okay, to a seated position. Okay, so I'm going to explain how to set up this next pose. We're going to do it with a few props. Okay, so first, if you have your fancy yoga props, you'll take a bolster and place that on your mat like so. Okay, if not using a bolster, don't worry. We can make this with several other things. So you might take pillows and again, prop up pillows kind of in a torso length position. I know this is kind of wonky looking, but it would work for our purposes here. If you have two blocks, we're just going to give you all the options. If you have two blocks, you could put your two blocks on your mat and then put another pillow on top of those, creating, again, this sort of bolster-like shape. Okay. And then what we're going to do is sit with the outer hip to that block. I'm going to bend my knees back like so. Now, my knees could stay stacked. This might be hard to see in the video. The knees will stay stacked, or your top knee could come back. So that would be my foot into the inner thigh. Okay. Then what I'm going to do with that pose is I'm going to turn towards the bolster. I'm going to turn towards that and then lay belly down onto my pillow or whatever kind of setup I'm lying on here. I'm going to turn my head to one side and take a rest like so. So I'm in a belly down twist. Again, the knees could be stacked up. The knees could be slightly off center, or for a much deeper twist, I can bring my foot into the inner thigh of the back leg. I'm turning my belly towards my bolster, again, placing that down. Now with my head, I can turn that same direction as my knees for a more gentle twist. Okay, more a deeper twist to the whole spine is going to be to turn my head away from the knee side. Okay, so again, allow yourself to get comfortable in the pose. I'm going to sit up a little bit while I talk you through it. Yeah. So any of these poses where we're belly down, there are awesome opportunities to feel your belly breathing into those props. So while we're here, let your belly press into your pillows underneath you. The arms on either side of you, elbows are about out from the shoulders, straight out from the shoulders. You can relax your shoulder blades on the back. So your arms shouldn't be holding any of your weight. Good, and from here, we're just gonna relax and let go. Really draw your breath down into your low belly and your low back. Feel your breath fill up all around the hips, low spine, middle spine, upper back. Good. Let your breath fill up really full, making space for the twist. And then when you exhale, give everything up. Let everything go. So like that poem that we read in the beginning, we're in this interesting and specific season right now. We've kind of curled into the ground. We've drawn inward. We've curled back. So just allow yourself that space, a little more space right now for stillness, a little more space for reflection, a little more space for quiet. We could look at it like an opportunity. We've spent a little more time in the pose now. You might press into your hands and slightly deepen the twist, so your body might be more warmed up into this pose now. You might even spend your last few breaths with your gaze twisted the other way if that's comfortable. Good. We'll be almost wrapping up on this side, so if you want a few more really deep breaths, just again to get the last little bit of juice out of the pose, go ahead and take a few more deep breaths. So to come out, we're just going to move our arms first. So pull your hands back, plug your arms into the ground, almost like a plank pose or like a chaturanga. And try to keep your spine and belly relaxed and just press into your hands. So we're coming out nice and slow, and you can untwist. And as you untwist, just take a comfortable seat for a moment. Take a breath all the way through the spine. Feel that unwinding of the twist. Okay, and so you guys at home, you can just turn around to the other side. Turn your opposite hip to your props. I'm gonna move my props to the other side so I can still face you while I do this. Okay, so second hip to the outer edge of, or the bottom edge of this prop, and then I'm gonna bend my knees. So the knees can come together, right? Most gentle, they can come slightly off of one another, or you could even pull that back leg further back, so our foot would be to the inner thigh. Okay, again, so my outer hip is set to my prop. This could be two pillows, it could be a bolster. And then I'm gonna turn, take hands either side of that, of the props, turn my belly towards it, and then lay belly down. Good. I'm gonna turn my head in the same direction as my knees and rest my hands either side of the props. What'll happen is as we spend a little bit of time in the pose, the body's gonna start to give in. So places that might have felt tight upon getting in are gonna start to open up as we stay a little bit longer. So as you've been here a few breaths, if you wanna push the hands down again, lift up and twist a little bit deeper. Again, belly more towards the props. Go ahead, deepen your twist, lay down again. Okay, head facing the same direction as the knees, less of a twist in the neck. If you want a bigger twist for your neck, turn your head opposite direction of your knees. Good, you stay. I'm gonna get up so I can keep track of time. Good. Okay, we'll stay here another 2 minutes. Even notice where your hands are touching the ground. Notice the texture underneath your hands. Maybe it's your yoga mat or the carpet. Notice any sounds you can hear. I'm not sure if you can hear in the video, but we have these lovely little frogs in Hawaii called koki frogs. Well, I guess it's debatable. Some people don't like them, but they make this sweet little croaking sound. You might be able to hear them. Maybe you're listening to your music. Maybe you're just listening to your breath. Whatever it is, tune into what you can hear. Bring your mind fully into the here and now. Notice the sensation of your belly pressing into your props as you breathe. Notice the weight of everything as it rests into the floor. Allow yourself to curl into yourself, right, as we hunker down for this interesting season, right, knowing that we'll reemerge on the other side. But how can we allow ourselves to just give in to what this is? Last few breaths on this side. Deep breaths in, deep breaths out. And you can pull your hands back to either side again and try to stay relaxed through your back as you push your hands into the floor. Come on up and out as you untwist. As you untwist, you might sit in a cross-legged position or some other way, and just allow yourself a moment. Notice those currents of energy sort of unwinding through the spine and through the breath. You might roll out through your head or neck. So for our next pose, using a block or some stiffer pillows, we're going to take a supported bridge. So again, lying down on our backs for this one. Okay, so depending on your props, this can work several different ways. We're going to lift our hips up. We could place a bolster here. That's actually really, really comfortable, cozy. Okay, so we want the hips up. You could use a block. Okay, you could place that block underneath your hips. If you had a couple couch pillows, again, I would put maybe even two or three, right? If your pillows are softer, you want your hips to be up and the support underneath to be solid enough that you won't sink down too much. Okay, so I really like my bolster for this one. So again, I'm going to slide that underneath the hips, right underneath the sacrum. I need that to be on kind of this flat bone just above the fleshy glutes and just below my lumbar spine. Okay, so we'll take our feet to the floor. If you want to let your knees fall in towards center, you could let your knees fall in towards center. You could let them stay hips width apart. We'll just be here a few moments, maybe a minute or 2 minutes. After you've taken time to adjust your props and adjust your body into a pose that feels perfect for you, right? And do take the time to get all the way comfortable, but then once you've done that, we'll start to really drop in and really let go. So this pose is just an extremely mild inversion, but it does have our hips higher than the heart, and the heart slightly higher than the head. And you can focus here on some deep cleansing breaths into the upper chest, into the upper rib cage, the shoulders, and then again, exhaling longer than your inhale. You might even let your body really start to melt at the end of those exhales. What could you do here to relax your body more? Relax your fingertips more, your shoulders more, your face and head and neck more. So you have permission to turn off all the way. And to let go all the way. To let the mind completely rest. So we're gonna walk our feet more towards center. Hey, I'm gonna pull my knees up from here. So with my hips propped up on something, I'm gonna pull my knees in. I'm gonna stretch my legs up toward the sky and just roll out my ankles, maybe shake out my legs and my feet. Okay, and then we'll bring the legs down. Press your feet into the floor, lift the hips up, and slide your prop out from underneath you. Good. Just take a little rest here. Lie flat on your back for a moment. We have a few more poses to go before we're done. Just take a moment to notice how is the body feeling and how is my mind feeling after about 40 minutes of restorative yoga poses. From here, I'm gonna pull my right knee into the chest, okay? And then what I want for this pose is, again, a pillow or a bolster. I'll use my couch pillow because probably more of us have those. So I'm gonna place these couch pillows to my side, okay? Pillows on my left side, right knee in towards my chest. And then I'm gonna bring that knee across the body for a twist, my knee coming down onto those pillows. Okay, so if you needed to, you could put two couch pillows on top of one another. I can place my knee so it rests a little higher up. That might be comfortable. And I'm gonna stretch my right arm out to the side. Okay, we won't be here too long, but just a couple moments in a really simple twist. I would recommend turning your gaze to the right for this pose. Again, we have pillows on our left side, right knee twisted over to the left side. And then gaze out to the right. And just allow a moment to catch yourself and catch yourself in your own mind, noticing what have I been distracted by lately, or what are the thoughts that have been nagging my mind, and if any of them are still there for the moment, could we just let them go? Right? We'll be able to tend to all that in about 15 minutes when class is done, or hopefully you're going to bed after this, right? But there will be time to tend to those thoughts. Right? Yoga and meditation is the practice of focusing on the present moment. Right? So no matter what's going on in the mind, we learn to kind of cut through that thought into the sweetness of the present moment. I'm going to draw that right knee up to center. Okay? We'll let that right leg drop down to the floor, and then take your pillows and shift them to the other side. Okay, so pillows are going to be against the right hip. Draw your left knee into the chest, and then bring your left knee across your body. Good, let that knee settle on your pillows, and extend your left arm to the left. Okay, for this pose, I'm gonna turn my gaze out over the left arm. Good, close the eyes and just settle in. Good. Right, for this one, really try to soften through the right side of the neck as you let the head twist as deep as it'll twist to your right. Relax your right shoulder. Again, every once in a while, take a really deep breath. Fill up all the way from your belly, low back, middle rib cage, upper rib cage. Fill up full, full, full. And when you exhale, let that all go. Melt. Really give way into the ground, everything you can. Good. We're going to bring that knee back up to center. You can draw your left knee into the chest. Good. Stretch your legs out on the ground. Again, take a little moment's rest. Okay, so for second to last pose, and then we'll make our way to Shavasana, we're going to take legs up the wall. So don't worry if you're not by a wall or if you don't have a wall without couches against it at your house. I'm going to give you a couple options. Okay, so we're familiar with this pose, legs up the wall, or maybe we're not, but I'm going to come to this wall and I'm going to put my legs up. Okay, while I do this, I'm going to set my hips. I'm going to talk you through it from here. You're going to set your hips slightly away from the wall so that the legs can lean into the wall at a slight angle. Right? If the legs are comfortable flat up the wall, fine. But if the legs flat up the wall, if your knees tend to buckle, then you might want to adjust your legs a little further away from the wall. Okay, if you're in the middle of your living room, you could put your legs up the couch. I teach in a lot of people's private homes, and so we do that a lot. We'll pull up next to the couch, put your calves and shins up on the couch with bent knees. You could even put a pillow underneath your knees on the couch to elevate the feet even higher. If you're in your bedroom, you can put your legs up the side of your bed. Okay, so there's many options to make this comfortable. If you wanted to put a pillow underneath your hips at the wall, you could do that. You could also pull a pillow underneath your head for this one. Okay. So I'll join you at the wall now. Go ahead and make yourself comfortable. This is a great pose to spend a little while, so we'll spend maybe 4 or 5 minutes here with our feet up the wall. Again, your arms could reach out in any direction. They could reach out to the sides. They could reach down by your waist. This is another great pose to put a pillow or a heavy blanket over your belly. It can feel calming and relaxing to have a little weight on the belly and the chest. And make sure the jaw is relaxed. See if you can soften the eyebrows and any lines in the forehead. Relax the forehead. Good. If it feels good for the first few moments in the pose to roll your ankles, or point and flex the feet, or spread and squeeze your toes. You could move a little more blood and lymph out of the feet if you move them around for a few moments to start. And then when that feels good, eventually you can rest the heels against the wall and rest completely. So this is a pose I'll do a lot before bed at night, or if I can't sleep at night, my bed is up against the wall. And so I'll turn around in my bed, lying in my bed, and put my feet up the wall this way. Restorative yoga poses are great to even take one at a time, right? To just take 5 or 10 minutes to do one of these poses is super effective in bringing down the nervous system. If you notice the mind is still moving or the mind is still distracted, just observe your breath. You don't have to breathe in any certain way in these poses, but just watch your breath flow in and watch your breath flow out. As the body and mind get calm, you'll notice that you'll breathe less. There might be little pauses after the end of your exhales, like moments of unintentional breath suspension. The calmer we get, the more normal that will become. Allow yourself to enjoy the stillness, enjoy the silence. So coming out of this pose, we're going to draw the feet down. You can bend your knees. Moving out slowly, if you have something on your belly, you can move that to the side. And we'll pull our knees into the chest. You can just roll to either side to come out of your pose. Okay. And the final pose we'll take as class is finishing up is Shavasana. But not just any Shavasana will make it extra delicious. So you might take a bolster or your two couch pillows could go underneath the knees. Okay, so something like this. I'm gonna move my stuff so it can set up all nicely. So something to go underneath your knees. Maybe a pillow to go underneath your head. Okay, and for final rest here, you might want to grab a blanket and cover up all the way. So I'm going to spread my blanket out from my toes to my shoulders. Okay, so we'll spread out completely. Again, you can prop some pillows up underneath your knees. You'll see I have my bolster underneath the knees here. And you can spread out, blanket all the way covering, arms stretched out to the sides. If you had an extra pillow or an extra little blanket, you might place it on your belly to relax even further. So I'm gonna come up out of Shavasana and walk you through kind of a yoga nidra relaxation. So take time again to set yourselves up in a comfortable Shavasana. And Notice your feet and your toes. Let your feet and your toes relax. Notice your ankles and your calves. Let your ankles and your calves relax. Let your hips and your whole back relax. Relax your spine and your shoulders. In your neck and head, in your jaw. Whole body relax. Whole body and mind relax. My hour time is up, and Instagram Live will cut us off at 1 hour, so I'm gonna say goodnight. Thank you for joining me tonight. Please stay as long as you like here in Shavasana. Rest longer than I'm able to stay with you if you like. There's a schedule of classes on my latest Instagram post. Please feel free to check it out and join us again this week. Thank you so much.
Namaste.
Thank you guys so much for joining me tonight. I hope you sleep well after this practice. Please feel free to like and subscribe. Check out this YouTube channel for other classes on all kinds of different topics. Also, if you'd like to make a donation for the class, you can donate on Venmo to @soulshapeyoga. Check out my Instagram @soulshapeyoga for a schedule of live classes that'll be up on Instagram this week. For more information, check in the description below. Thanks again.